You know, I was thinking, as many times as we have, as I've watched you, and as we've been together on programs, and as I've been to a theater where you were performing, and as long as we've known each other, I don't think I've ever interviewed you on television, have I?
Before? No.
And historic first, ladies and gentlemen. Really good to be able to talk to you. I was over at the Fairmont the other night, watched you and Sid, and fell out of my chair as usual. The brilliance is brilliant, and sometimes you forget, although I did see 10 from your show of shows.
Yeah.
Which you both did. Do you enjoy working with him again?
Oh, sure. I always love working with Sid. We've worked together much more often than people realize. Not on television, but we've done two plays together. And we haven't been as far apart as people think we have, because we haven't been in front of the camera.
In those days, I'm just wondering, now we're in an era of women's liberation and whatnot. In those days now, when you started Show of Shows, were you limited as to the type of comedy that you could do or get away with or be permitted?
Well, the censorship was much more strict than it is now. For instance, I'm doing a strip over at, not really a
oh,
strip.
Oh, yeah, that's a fun
Over at the hotel. And when I first did that on television, the censors said, oh, no. And so I had to, then all the censors came over from the studio and they looked at it and said, oh, mercy, no. So I couldn't do it. Well, you've seen the strip.
Yeah, I have more clothing on than an Arctic. yeah, I don't know what. It's a takeoff on
the strip. I have a coat right down to my ankles, which I never take off.
But back then they just thought that the idea of having it as a striptease was not to be done.
That it was in my mind a strip was bad enough. And so another thing, we did a satire on From Here to Eternity, in which I played the dance hall hostess. And obviously she would have come on kind of doing, oh, I don't mean really big bumps or things, but let's say with more movement. My movement was very limited because that sort of thing wasn't allowed. Yeah. And if you did a marital sketch in which the argument, because Sid and I, mostly our marital sketches were based on husband and wife arguments, and if it happened to be in the bedroom, we couldn't be in bed. I mean, twin beds even.
Is that right?
We had to be sitting on the bed. You know, an argument very often happens just before you go to sleep.
Right.
But we had to be standing up.
Times have changed.
Haven't they changed, though? Wang.
Among changes, now you and your husband, King Donovan, have done a lot of work
yes.
together, and much of which I've enjoyed when I got a chance to see it. Are more and more couples doing things now, on not only on the road, but in... Is it an age where we hear erosion of the marriage as an institution and increase of divorce and everything, but it seems to me that I see more couples doing things together.
Many, many, many years ago, it was very average for husbands and wives to act together. And as a matter of fact, the wife very often, her name was the husband's name. She didn't use her maiden name. It was always Mrs. Sarah Siddons, let's say,
yeah.
or that's the first name I could think of. But it was part of the protocol of theater for the wife to use her married name. And it was a common thing. I think then it became uncommon.
Yeah,
and now I think it's going back to the cycle of it being common.
Right. I don't think of you as Mrs. Donovan, I guess, because it is, although you're linked together with King.
No, nobody ever calls me Mrs. Donovan.
I guess not. That's her name, though. That's
yeah.
Mrs. Donovan. When I saw you at
Sounds
the window...
Sounds nice, doesn't it?
Would you answer to that?
Of course I would. Should I change my name to Imogene Donovan?
There's the reason. You establish a name, you establish a career, and obviously there's an advantage to keeping it. There's nothing wrong with that.
Customer. I think it'd be marvelous if you could change your name, like, every 3 months. I like new names.
That'd confuse. I understand there are Indian tribes that did that.
Really? Maybe
change their name every now and then, whenever they felt.
Possibly, like. I was an Indian in another life.
We ought to give you a name right now because Imogene has promised to do a bit out of the act with Sid. This is a solo thing now. That is the quintessential torch singer of all time. Do you want to explain anything more about it before you do it?
Well, for those. Maybe torch singers were not in style for a while, but they're coming back in again. And these ladies always would sing about the men in their lives, and the men would treat them so terribly. They'd abandon them. I can't tell you what these men would do according to the songs. But no matter what the men did, they loved them. And their love went forever. And it always seemed to me that they were happy being so miserable. So...
Okay, you leave this microphone here.
Okay.
We got one down there for you.
All right.
I'll go down there with you to get started.
Okay. Doesn't ever send me pretty flowers. Jim never helps you cheer my lonely hours. Don't know why I'm so crazy for Jim. Never tells me I'm his heart's desire. I never seem to set his love afire. Gone are the years I've wasted on him. I know that someday Jim will up and leave me. Oh. But even if he does, you can believe me, I'll go on carrying the torch for Jim. Forget the very first time I ever saw Jim. He was passing by and stopped to pick up a cigar. But he picked me up instead. I must have been lying there for a good hour. I know that someday Jim will up and leave me, but even if he does, you can believe me, I'll go on carrying the torch, for I'm not wild about Harry, not Tommy, not Dickie.
Imogene's going to be back a couple of shows later with